ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and I am being bombarded with tons and hundreds of mails. My God, Venus is retrograde. I have already made the video on my live session, but people are mailing me so much. My WhatsApp, my email, my Facebook Messenger, everything is simply bombarded with one thing from last 10-15 days. I am saying, oh my God, Venus has gone retrograde. My relationship is, it's about to collapse, it's about to fall apart, it's about to break. My God, what to do? My marriage is going to end. People are sending me requests, can you please check my horoscope and say that do I have a divorce or am I going to have a breakup? It seems like that. Oh my God. And then there are people who are single. They are messaging me that, oh my God, I am getting remembrances of my ex-boyfriend or girlfriend. My ex is messaging me back. What to do? Should I get back with that person? Should I get back with my boyfriend or my ex-girlfriend? Or I am already in a relationship. And then there's another third person who I am getting attracted to, or the other person is getting attracted to me, and that person is trying to pull me from this existing relationship, or I am feeling like I should end this relationship and enter a new relationship. My God, I am like, what's going on, man? So either people are in a relationship or they are not. People are, it's like it's going crazy because Venus is going retrograde now. It's going retrograde in Mool Trikon. So it is, the energy is very intense there. Alright, so there you go. This is a video on how to deal with Venus retrogrades. My God, I already made the video, but I'm again making, this will not be a astrological analysis that I have done in the earlier video. I will give the link of the that video in the description. So you can first watch that, and then you can watch this, or you can watch this, then you can watch that video. It has around 6,000-7,000 views. Okay, so if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation regarding your Venus retrograde or anything which is bogging you currently, then you can please go to my website. You will find the link to my website in the description section of all of my videos, not only this video. Okay, down below in the description you will find. And before I begin, oh my God, today I must say this. God is there with you. He is there with you all the time. He will still be there with you till the time Venus is retrograde. My God, November 15, that judgment day, as in Islam, they say, na, Kayamat. As in the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, it is said, Pralay, my God, Pralay is coming, it seems. So he will be there with you, don't worry, okay? So now see, let's understand the energy of a retrograde planet. They say retrograde planet is very close to the earth, okay? So forget all these astrological terms and when a planet goes retrograde, forget astronomy, forget astrology. Just think like this. A planet is going in its normal motion like that. Normally, okay? Like Venus is going 25 days around, it changes one sign. So imagine there is a school and there are students who are just studying. Some of them are studying, some of them are sitting in the front bench, some of them are sitting in the middle part of the class, and some of them are sitting at the back benchers, you see. So when the classes are going on normally, there's no problem. You see, some are talking, some are gossiping, some are just hovering around, and some of them are like, no, no, we need to take notes. And some of them are like watching Facebook, WhatsApp, I don't know, whatever. So everything is fine. It's taking the normal course when the planet is direct. But suddenly there's an exam, or there's like a surprise test which is declared. My God. Surprise test. But the benefit of knowing astrology is we already know when the test is going to come, because we know Venus goes retrograde every 18 months. Around that time it will be retrograde. It goes retrograde the least among all the planets. We know that, right? So last time, March 5th around, it was retrograde. 2017, it went retrograde in the sign of Pisces. And now exactly after, around the period of 18 months, it is going retrograde in the sign of Libra. 8 houses away from there, okay? Always 8 houses. So suppose this is like a sudden surprise test, because surprise test has to be sudden only. And then there's this examiner which comes and says, now no sitting here, there, I decide where you sit. You sit there, she sits here, and you sit here. And you write and I tell you the questions. Alright? And then you're like, my God, surprise test. I don't know the answer, man. Hey, John, where are you? Abhe kaha gaya? Where are you, man? Bacha le, bhagwa. That is exactly what is a retrograde planet. Now, the outsiders, the general public, they don't know this. Because they don't have any knowledge of astrology. But the beauty of those people who know astrology is they know that the surprise test is going to come this time. Okay? So, you can prepare well in advance. So, then what happens when there is the surprise test? Your true colors come out. Should I repeat? Your original colors, your actual understanding of the subject comes out. That is exactly what happens when a planet goes retrograde. Therefore, when Venus is going retrograde now, crazy. In last 18 months, I have never seen such a crazy time. My God. Mars Ketu was conjunct. I have not seen any such craziness in my WhatsApp or in my Messenger. But I don't know. From the time Venus has gone retrograde, I don't know what has happened. Okay, so now see what is happening is Venus is now going retrograde. So now it's like saying in the area of relationships, there's a surprise test. Oh, he said he loves you, but suddenly he's not answering your calls. Maybe he loves you, but he also loves somebody else, right? So suppose there's a question, MCQ. Ramesh loves Sally, suppose. Ramesh is a Hindu guy and Sally is a Christian. Suppose, take an imaginary world, Ramesh versus Sally. So, Ramesh has been asked this question. Do you like Rama? Do you like Sita? Or do you like Sally? Or do you like, let's take another Muslim girl's name. Na? Do you like Aisha? Alright. So, there are two Hindu girls. There's one Muslim girl and there's one Christian girl. So, suppose he is deeply, madly in love with Sally. But he also has some feelings for Aisha, you know. And now what will happen is, he will be forced to make a decision. And in while making that decision, he will have to introspect. Because see, when you are giving an exam, what happens? You are thinking 10 times before writing. Generally, you are just taking a pen and writing in copies. Or in your book, sometimes you are making notes. You're not very attentive that time. But when you are writing an exam, you're like, oh my God, anything goes wrong, I lose marks here. So when you are feeling that your husband or your wife or your girlfriend or your boyfriend is not messaging you, or they are not replying to you, or they are behaving weirdly, they are actually not behaving weirdly, they are behaving the way they should have behaved. Should I repeat? They are exactly behaving the way they want to behave. Now you'll say, oh no, no, it is not like that. She was not like this. Now only she is behaving like this. No, no, my dear sir, she was always like this. You were a fool who could not see that. And now when she is forced to give the exam, there you go, the results are out. So, during Venus retrograde, if there is any relationship, if that relationship doesn't deserve to stay, it will not stay. It will fall apart. Should I repeat? It will fall apart. And here's the good news. It should fall apart. It's good for you. It's good for both of you, actually. Yes, it's perfect for both of you. Because if you are not able to pass the exam, how will you get the degree? Degree is like you get married or you stay together. Something like that you can take. So if you are not able to survive this period, which is during the exam. Suppose there is a doctor who is giving the final exam of MBBS and the person is failing. How in the universe will he treat patients? How? He or she will... It's they will kill people basically. Instead of curing, they will damage whatever whatever is remaining in their bodies of their patients. So, if during Venus retrograde, your relationship is becoming very intense and you are being forced to make a decision, take my words, make that decision and you will be happy later on. And if you hover around the surface, if you try to cover it, beat around the bush, as in Asmis they say, Sale bare kubua. You are, see, during Venus retrograde, you will see, you will always get a voice inside. Always it will happen. This will not work, this will work, this will work, this will work, this will not work, this will not work. Don't ignore that voice. Now, this does not mean that everybody's relationships will be fall. It doesn't mean that. There are so many people in this world. But if you are getting that voice inside, do not ignore it. So sit down after the exam. What you do? You take the, you go to internet and you check. Like for UPSC or for IIT, there are answers after the exam is over. Yes, this question maybe probably answer is this. So during this time, you need to do that. You actually need to ask yourself, will we be happy together? Will I be happy first of all? Forget the other party. You have to ask this question yourself. During Venus retrograde, one question you must ask yourself. I don't care. You are single. You are in a relationship. You are divorced. You are widowed or you are married or whatever it is. I don't care. Ask yourself this question. Am I happy without somebody? Should I repeat? Am I happy without somebody? If the answer is no, then it is a big alarm. Because you cannot get happiness when you stay with another person. You can only share it. Should I repeat? You cannot get happiness by staying with somebody. You can only share your existing level of happiness with somebody. Instead of giving statements like, be with someone who makes you happy. I don't know from where this statement has come. Nobody is going to make you happy. It is, you know who is going to make you happy? It is you. You are already, go and look into the mirror. That's the person, you see. You are responsible for your own happiness. If your life is boring, freaking disgusting, and you are sitting and wondering that, oh, my girlfriend will come and she will behave like she will behave like an angel, or my boyfriend will come and he will just rock the show. Oh my God. He will rock everybody and he will rock you also out. Nikal fek dega aapko, whoever that person is. So whenever Venus is retrograde, always ask this question to yourself. Am I happy? Am I doing those things which give me fulfillment? Suppose you like to paint. Are you painting? Suppose you like to write poetry. Are you writing poetry? Suppose you like to play the guitar. Are you playing? Suppose you like to play the kartal, as I'm going to play now. Okay. This is a kartal which I had purchased when I went to India recently. So suppose I like to play the kartal. Okay. Because these are also, you know, in one way Venus only, musical instruments. So suppose I'm playing this. So I have to ask myself this question. If I like to play this, am I playing this? If the answer is no, then you have to ask yourself, why in the universe am I not doing that? Because when you are not happy, your relationship becomes miserable. Because you have nothing to give, you see. If you don't, if your wallet is empty, how can you do charity? Relationship is basically what? There is one person who is totally full within himself or herself. Full means the person is happily doing those things which give him fulfillment. Suppose he's in a job which he likes to do. I mean, like doesn't mean that he's like bubbling with enthusiasm or joy, but he's doing what he wants in life. He's going for his purpose in life. If his purpose is to become a doctor, he is doing that happily. If his purpose is that he wants to become an engineer, then he is doing that happily. Or he wants to be a spiritual guru, that also he is doing happily. Or he wants to open a channel on YouTube, that he is doing. So, that when the person is doing happily, then he can share that happiness with a girl. But suppose you are not having any purpose in life and you are just roaming headlessly, and then you are thinking, if a man is thinking, oh, you know, if only I get married, my problems will be solved. Oh my God, that's like, you are bored. So when a man is bored with his life, he also attracts another girl who is also bored. Go and check the life of any man who is just watching TV, cricket, or all this nonsense, who is just wasting time, has no goal, no ambition. They don't know why they are getting up in the morning. They are not getting up because they want to, because adrenaline is throwing them out of their bed. Oh my God, if I don't go, the boss will fire me, no? If that is your situation, look at the girlfriend or the wife of that person. She will be equally boring. Boring doesn't mean that the opposite should be there. You are like bubbling with joy, enthusiasm. Yeah. That's not the opposite of boring. Boring, there's a difference, you see. Interesting means that you are doing things which make you happy. It can be monotonous also. Like I am making these YouTube videos. It is monotonous. Every day I am doing the same thing. But when you are happy doing what you love, the routine will not become boring, you see. People say, oh, routine is boring, you know. Artificially, they will try to spice up things. They will say that, oh, change your room, you know. Change this curtain. No, it is not going to work like that. You change your room 100,000 times. It is not going to work. Whatever vastu remedy you do, it is not going to. You have to sit and ask this question to yourself. Am I happy without my spouse? Or am I just wasting time after coming home instead of cultivating spiritual knowledge or doing things which I love? Or am I just wasting time? You know, oh, this is so terrible, you see. Oh, I am just watching Game of Thrones. The other day somebody was telling me that, oh, you know, I have to go because I have this serial, you know. Entertaining, basically. They are just trying to fill up the filthy, disgusting boredom which they have in life. You are just trying to beat around the bush. If you are seeking entertainment all the time, why don't you seek enlightenment? If that is what you are doing, if the only reason you are happy is, like many of my friends I know who are in Bangalore, the only reason they are happy is there's a new restaurant which has opened in Bangalore. And you know how cities like Bangalore, Bombay, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Pune are. Every week there's a new restaurant opening. So what they are doing? They're going and checking the menu. Oh, you know, today's, like especially I've seen vegetarians. Ah, Indian vegetarians. What to, kya kehna aap sab ke baare mein? Indian vegetarians I have seen. And you also must see these people, okay? They're so funny sometimes. Of course, I am included in that. I also do that sometimes when I go to India. But the thing is so funny. They will go to every veg restaurant and they will say, oh, give me one paneer makhni, one paneer butter masala. It's the same dish, man. Dono ek hi dish hai. Kisko bewakoof bana raha hai? Paneer makhni, paneer tikka masala, paneer butter masala, sab same hai, the gravy same. Only there are some external things which they do. Now somebody is from hotel management, they will blast me in the comments. Oh, you don't know anything about cooking. Utana nahi pata yaar. I don't know that much how much you know, but at least I know that those three items are the same. Any layman can tell it. If tomorrow I give you a dish and I ask you, is it paneer makhni? Or is it paneer butter masala? Or is it paneer tikka masala? I guarantee, I bet you cannot answer that question. Of course, paneer tikka masala, maybe you can answer, because they will grill the paneer and the capsicum. If that is the only reason why you are happy, that okay, today I will go to this restaurant and eat paneer tikka masala. Tomorrow I'll eat shahi paneer. Tomorrow I'll eat paneer lavabdar. Na? Non-vegetarians, my God. Chicken 65. Tumhara 56 ho jayega, sir. 56 se jyada, pata nahi koi jiyega ki nahi. What all things people do, you see? So, these are escapisms which people have. So instead of doing things which will give them happiness, they are just running after pleasure. So these people have the most difficult times when Venus goes retrograde, because they themselves are miserable, they are empty, they are hollow, their lives are filthy, boring, disgusting, dry. Oh my God, it's so boring to stay with these people sometimes. And then they will complain that, oh, my spouse is not reciprocating. Are kon rahega tere saath? Who will stay with you? Will you go and stay near a person who is diseased? Suppose they have some very terrible disease. If you go near them, now you will get that disease. Suppose it's a disease like that. We will not want to go near that person. Or even if we go, we'll take precaution. That's how your wife or husband is behaving. So during Venus retrograde, you don't have to do anything. You just have to do one thing. You have to make sure, you have to ask this question to yourself. Am I happy with my life? Do I have a schedule where I am putting things, I am prioritizing things? And especially including spiritual practices in the morning and in the evening if required. Like Vishnu mantras are generally chanted in the morning and Shiva mantras are generally chanted in the night or in the evening or before sunrise. So depending on whatever your guru or your astrologer has suggested, depending on that will vary. But the fact of the matter is, even if you are not doing mantras, even if you are not cultivating spiritual knowledge, at the mundane level, at least if you are doing things which you like, that will also save you when Venus goes retrograde. Otherwise that can happen. And there's this other category. Oh, my ex-boyfriend is messaging. My ex-girlfriend is coming back. She's coming to you simply because she's bored. Do not entertain her. Do not entertain him. Wo bore hai, tujhe bhi bore karke jayega. Phir tu mujhe message bhejta rahega. Or, oh, I am remembering my ex. You know, this happened, that happened. Are? That person who did not value you, who kicked you away from his life, you are thinking of that person. Huh. Of course, it's easier said than done. But as I said, the point has to be understood that if we are not happy, we cannot give happiness to others. All right. So when Venus goes retrograde, sit down and think, what can I do to make my life better? What can I do to make my life more fulfilling? What can I do? That is something which you have to ask yourself. How can I improve myself? How can I improve my life? How can I improve my definition of pleasure? When you do that, you will see all the problems of Venus will be solved. Yes, it will happen. Still, there are 15 days. You can still try it. Try it for 1 week. And then you mail me later on. Otherwise, I ensure you will be running behind astrologers. Asking remedies for Venus retrograde. Blah, blah, blah. This, that. You chant a million mantras. Nothing is going to work. Till the time you do not do what Venus wants, it will not happen. Alright, so that is what we need to do when Venus goes retrograde. We have to find activities in our life which make us more fulfilled internally as a complete individual. Do not search for your better half. I don't know from where this nonsensical idea has come. Better half, it means I am incomplete. No, you have to be a complete individual in yourself. Only then other people will be able to stay with you. Otherwise, they will get attracted to you because of your looks. Or the makeup, or the way you speak. Ah, yeah. That's why have you seen beautiful people? I know so many people who are very handsome, who look very good. I know so many, some girls I know. I've seen their horoscopes. My God. So beautiful. It's like, if you see them, you can't stop staring. They're so beautiful. And yet, they have had 4 or 5 breakups. How in the universe that's happening? Because the men are not willing to stay with them. Why? Because that's only the beauty, you know. One day, the very soon, within 2-3 days, the beauty is faded off. As in Hindi, they say, na, 4 din ki chandani. Aajkal to Kaliyug mein 4 din kya 4 ghante ki bhi nahi hoti chandni. Anyways, whatever it is. So when that is gone, then it's over, you see. All the lullabies, the beautiful songs, the red roses, everything is fade, gone. Nobody likes to stay with somebody who is not happy inside. And if you are happy inside, you will also attract another person who is happy. Otherwise, your relationship cannot work. I'm telling you, guaranteed. If you are happy inside, individually, you are fulfilled. I don't care who you are a man or a woman, doesn't matter. Then you will also attract another person who is like that. So instead of wasting time going on dating websites, doing this, doing that, flirting with the opposite sex, instead of wasting time doing all this, just focus on yourself, improve yourself. Then you see 10 members of the opposite sex, they will run behind you. And then you will have the mic to choose. Now also you may say, oh, 10 men are running behind me, I will choose them. No, they're not running behind you. They're running behind themselves maybe. If you are miserable, miserable people will run you. Your vibe attracts your tribe. Should I repeat? Your vibe attracts your tribe. So if you are unhappy, you will also attract. Because see, it's very synchronous. You are unhappy. You are finding somebody who will try to fill the vacuum. Okay? So then, suppose you are a girl, and then there will be another man who will be searching a girl to fill his void. So then what will happen is, the girl will think that, oh, if I get him, I can fill the void. And then the man is also thinking, if I get her, I can fill the void. But it's like this, you see. It can't be like this. It has to be like this. Two complete individuals coming together. Only then there can be happiness. That is what I will say. So improve yourself, improve your life. Kick out, throw out all those activities which degrade you. Eating meat, drinking, smoking, indulging in illicit sex, watching pornography, watching watching adult material in the internet. I was so happy. So many people have messaged me that after seeing my videos, they have given up pornography, they have given up eating meat. I'm so happy to hear it. I wish more and more people, they message me like this. That's the negation. But the main thing is, you have to do spiritual practices and you have to calm down your mind. Only then you can know. Many people, there are people who don't know what they want in life. So first 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, you do spiritual practices. Stabilize yourself. Only then you can know, beta, baba, beti, kya chahiye tumhe. If your mind is blocked, you don't know what you want. You are just doing job because everybody is doing. You are doing. Everybody is opening startup, so I also open a startup. You know, everybody is getting married, so I also get married. No, it doesn't work like that. All right, long video as usual. So that is how you survive a Venus retrograde. Okay, and it is a testing time. It's not a difficult time. It's a testing time. Now it is up to you that you pass it or not. Okay. But ask this question to yourself. Am I happy in life? Or am I just wasting time, giggling, laughing, doing this, doing that? If that is who you are, then whoa, you will have it when Venus goes right away. Okay. There you go. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with so many people. My God. Forget about the other video, Venus retrograde, what it will do in Libra or whatever it is. Forget your horoscope. Throw astrology. Don't bring astrology here. Astrology is not needed here. You do not need to write in the comments, oh, my Venus is in 20th house in the sign of Lulu. What Lala is going to do? Na? From Lulu, Lala is expecting. And Haha is thinking what to do. No, nothing. No astrology. Nothing is required. Forget astrology. For God's sake, forget astrology for some time. Yes, I am telling this. When you know where is the problem, stop running to people. Because the problem is inside you, it is not outside. Okay? There you go. If you want a consultation, then please go to my website. You can still go to my website and book a reading if you want. But I would say if this is the problem, then please don't come to me, okay? I will not be able to help you. It is only you and God and your guru. These three have to solve this problem. You, God and your guru. You three have to sit down together. As I said, God is there with you. So wherever you are, God is also there. Okay? Then do things which you like and be a happy individual, fulfilled without anybody. Okay? Then you see things will improve. Okay? Until next time when Venus goes retrograde, my God. I hope you survive till then. Okay? Bye-bye. See you.